Good Erev Shabbos. The video is Lilin Shmas Vishmo Baruchim Chayim Tzvidoi. Before Shleim with the Chayfun Bas Paramel Yamalka, we're going into Pasha Shoiftim. In Shoiftim, we have a description of what it means to be a Jewish soldier. Now, besides the, you know, of course, today we have the Tzava of Israel. And as we mentioned many times, how holy every soldier is. I went to Coren B'Yavne, she was Coren B'Yavne. And it's actually one, I think, of the first Hesder Yeshiva. And I had a chavrusa there, I think his name was Yaron. And he was in the army. And he wrote me a letter, most amazing letter. I think I once shared it to the Yoram, it's kedai to review it. And the letter really is discussing Pasha Shefti. In Pasha Shefti, it describes the fact that who should not go out to war. So there's a whole list. People that got married, someone that just had a vineyard, someone that just dedicated a house. And then it also says, Aloshna Yore, someone that's scared of Avera Shabiyode. The Gemara says that, what is this big Avera that a person should be worried not to go to war, not to be a soldier in the army of Israel? So the Gemara says, someone that's Sach ben Tfilin Shal Yad, Tfilin Shal Rois, someone that speaks between the Tfilin of the Yad, Tfilin Shal Rois. Doesn't sound like the biggest Avera. Baruch Hashem, people are careful not to speak, but the truth is, even if you spoke, so then you make two brachas and there's Tfilin Shal Rosh. There's halachas, what to do. Obviously, people, it happens, discuss in Shulchan Aruch. Why is this the Avera? So he wrote me the most beautiful response, and it connects to the end of Maseches Nazir Yerushalmi. I'm finishing off Yerushalmi and Maseches Nazir and Mechavrusa. Ends off such a peculiar discussion. The last Mishnah Nazir discusses whether Shmuel HaNavi, the famous Shmuel HaNavi, was he a Nazir or not? Was he a Nazir like Shimshon or not? So the Mishnah basically has a dispute between Rabbi Yossi and Rabbi Meir. Rabbi Nora is Rabbi Meir, and Rabbi Yossi basically says, well, the Pasuk says Moira. Moira doesn't mean anything about Nazir. It means that Hashem guaranteed he won't have any fear from any human beings. Okay, Rabbi Meir says Moira means, just like it says Mora, the word Mora, Moira Le'aval Rosha, which means a razor not going on his head. So Rabbi Noroi turns to Rabbi Yossi and says, I don't understand. You're telling me that the reason that Moira means fear, which it really is a simple translation, except it's with a hey, not an aleph. Okay, the hey and aleph switch around. But then he says, you know that it says that Shmuel was scared to go and do and crown David HaMelech when Hashem told him to do so. He said, well, how can I do that? And Shaul's going to hear and kill me. So how can you say that Shmuel and Navi wasn't scared of human beings? Now this is very difficult to understand. What do you mean? If it's a pasuk, then of course Rabbi Yossi also knew that. What's the explanation? So I thought of the following. If you look in the Chovos HaLevavos Shaar Bitachon, like we always say, the most important sefer that we need to study every single day, if at least 5 minutes a day, Shaar Bitachon, to really create and internalize our trust in Hashem. There he asks a bomb question. He says, and this will, I think, answer our question. He says, how can it be that Shmuel is scared of going? Hashem told him, go. If there's anything better than a guarantee from Hashem, a direct guarantee from Hashem, you're not going to be scared. The answer is, of course Shmuel wasn't scared internally. He just had an obligation to do ishtadlus. Whenever we go out to war, whenever we go and we do our job, we're not supposed to believe that it's the job that gets us the money. It's not the war, it's not the weapons, it's the ishtadlus. We have an obligation to do our ishtadlus to make it look like it's not a miracle, but at the end of the day, we need to know in our head that it's Hashem. So I was thinking, simple, of course Shmuel wasn't scared, and therefore there's no kasha against Rabbi Yossi. Now how does this connect to our beautiful parasha and my letter from my friend? He said like this, he said, Tefillin Shel Rosh, we know, is connected to Neshama Shebemoichi, is the spiritual part of us. The Neshama, the Tefillin Shel Yad, is connected to Lev, connected to Leshab Lesaguf, the body. When a person speaks between Tefillin Shel Yad and Tefillin Shel Rosh, it's not just about the speaking. It's a separation between the spiritual and the physical. It's when a person forgets a soldier, and the most dangerous place to forget this connection is at the battle. So much so that the Chinuch, based on the Pasuk, says, you're not allowed to be scared. You're not allowed to be scared. No. Because internally, we have to trust Hashem. And we have to do our ishtadlus. And the last thing we want to do is separate that connection between, and this was a letter that my friend wrote me. So beautiful, so appropriate for a Jewish soldier in the army of Israel. Have an amazing Shabbos.